Hello, dear students. This is Dr. Srinivas Paji, Assistant Professor of English, Government First Aid College. Sir, the college is affiliated to Tumkur University, Karnataka. And this is the session in which I am going to speak on one of the important essayist by name Richard Steele. Richard Steele, he was a remarkable and revolutionary essayist of the Revolution period, like Collymore Goldsmith. In the previous sessions, we have discussed something about Oliver Goldsmith and his writings and his contributions, and particularly The Man in Black, the essay. And the second important essay that you are going to study in the syllabus. Richard Steele is a name which was very popular when essay was developing the restoration movement. We never think of Steele without Addison. Joseph Addison and Steele, they were two faces of the same coin. They wrote together, a contemporary essayist, the popular. We never think of essay without these two important essayists. The restoration period. Their essays reflects restoration features. Now let us see something about Richard Steele, his background, his works, and so on. This is a session of the topic that is a note on Richard Steele. Richard Steele was a popular essayist of the Restoration English literature. He lived between 12th March 1672 to 1st September 1729. During this period he lived. He was an Irish writer and a British. See that there shall be a question in your mind that many poets I spoke on my various sessions, and many writers were mostly Irish writer, Anglo-Irish writer, and writer, Irish writers. Why Irish people, the people of Ireland, were so intellectual and writers and scientists? Irish people, they were having wonderful background and history of the land in which they were brought up, and they contributed a lot to the literature as well. W.B. Yeats, in one of my sessions, I told you that he was an Irish popular poet of the 20th century, the great modern poet. And here the Richard Steele is also an Irish writer. He is a politician. He not only a writer but also a politician. He was an Irish intellectual. He was always remembered as co-founder with his friend Joseph Addison for the magazine Tatler. Tatler was a magazine that they both, that is Steele and Joseph Addison, they started this journal. It was a popular journal during the Revolution period. The popular magazine where many the writers were writing, it was publishing, and it was accessible to the people of the period. They used to read and comment. And yes, it was so popular, the magazine that is a Tatler. Therefore, I told you that we never think of Addison without Steele, and Steele without that is Joseph Addison. Altogether, both of them, they wrote a lot. And they contributed a lot to the literature of the Restoration period. His first published work, the most important work, that is Christian Hero. And they entitled it was as a Christian Hero in 1701, and where he attempted to point out the difference between the perceived and the actual masculinity. Christian Hero was was his first published work where he was thinking of the sex, that is masculinity and femininity, gender, about he mainly focused on this. It was also a popular beginning work of the it's a Steele. When Steele served in the army, he was not only a writer, a politician, and a soldier. He was a nationalist and he was a statesman of the land. And he served in the army. When Steele served in the army, he expressed his ideas of a pamphlet of moral instruction. When he was serving in the army, he thought of writing something that he got an idea. That is, it was the beginning, that is, he wanted to write something on pamphlet. It is a piece of writing where he is going to circulate the pamphlet to the hands of the people available to read, with a piece of writing about the politics and some of the people from the army, that was the condition. And the mainly focus in the pamphlet on the moral instruction to the people. Why moral instruction was mainly focused on the pamphlets and his works? Because when the morality and when there was no ethics, then it is the need of the hour and it is the responsibility of the writer as a cultural representative. He should do something in order to change the system. Therefore, by writing the the pamphlets, you would like to give some morality to the people. It was the purpose of writing and introducing pamphlet. The Christian Hero was ultimately ridiculed for what some thought was hypocrisy, because Steele did not necessarily follow his own preaching. Why, whenever we speak on morality and ethics and the discipline, it is not quite easy to advise others, but one should be very careful of putting every step, whether I am walking on the right path or the wrong path. These things are going to decide whether the writer is good at his writing and is staying one and leaving other. There should be a correlation between his writing and his life. But it was not so popular, but it was an attempt made by Steele to do something as far as morality is concerned, ethics is concerned. He was criticized for publishing the booklet about morals when he himself enjoyed drinking occasionally during and debauchery around town. It is quite common when the people like steel or anybody else that is preaching something, the people, hundreds of eyes were observing him and they are trying to find out his parts quite naturally. Now let us come to the contributions of the Vidya Steel in the field of literature and essay particularly. Steel wrote a comedy that is, he wrote that is the place also, comedy that's the same year titled The Funeral. The Funeral was a very popular comedy by him. It is a comedy of manners. This play met with wide success. Was performed at Drury Lane, bringing him to the attention of the king and the wig of the party. Just he was serving in the army and he was publishing pamphlets and writing something in the journals. But immediately there was a change his platform to write. That is, he started writing the play. That is the play. The Funeral, it was very popular and it could get success. And he was honored and respected by the king. And he was invited to the big party and all that. It was the immediate success of the writer when he had changed the form. That is the play. Next, he wrote The Lying Lover, one of the first sentimental comedies. He also wrote another play that sentimental comedy and comedy of manners. They were popular forms during the restoration period. So they introduced and we see that. In 1705, he wrote The Tender Husband with contribution from Madison Stand. Later that year, wrote Prologue to the Mistake by John Weinberg, also an important member of the Wicket Cat Club. With tradition of steel. This is how he did not stop writing. Immediately there was he changes his platform and he's going to write one after the other and he is getting a success and doing something to the society, being a writer, having such a responsibility as an intellectual and Irish writer. Now let us see the popular journals, that is the Tatler, it was a very popular journal. Let us see something about Tatler. The Tatler was his first and the most popular journal appeared, and he wrote this periodical under the pseudonym and biggest staff and gave an entire fully developed personality. And he got an identity by writing and publishing the popular journal, that is the Tatler. As a writer, he was identified, he was respected, and he got a wonderful place in the literary platform. He described his motive in writing Tatler in order to expose the false arts of life, to pull off the disguises of cunning, vanity, and affection. The main focus of the Steele in any of his writings is exposing the cunning nature, vanity, and affection, and intrigues, and luxurious life, and boasting on life, and giving trouble to the people, and easy way of leading the life. And these the manners that were exposed by writing the Tatler. He recommended a general simplicity in our dress, our discourses, and our behavior. As a writer, he used to advise the people and to follow the principle of simple living and high thinking. This was the principle of his life and his writing. Therefore, he used to advise the people like this. And later, let us see the Steele as a significant writer of the 18th century. Richard Steele had contributed a lot to the essay in the 18th century, restoration literature. Edison is still the contemporary writer who popularized prose writing to expose Edison's society. They wanted to, that is, hold the mirror to reflect the mannerism of the people. Whenever they got liberty and liberation, they got. They immediately they started living what they how they like, and when liberty was misused, they never think of the value of the liberty as well, and then it was harmful to the society, and it is that definitely hurting the feeling of others and troubling others. These things should be avoided. Therefore, when the writers of the period, including the Steele, observed all these things, they wanted to expose these faults and follies of the people and their manners. It was a tool for them to ridicule the introduce and facts of the people. Just the people, they are spending much money and for passions, and they are doing some interviews. These things were ridiculed by the tool of writing essays and novels and plays by the writer like the that is Richard Steele and George Pritchard. The present essay, Trumpet Club, for your study is one such an attempt to understand the writings of the Steele and feel at its importance. Syllabus in the second sem you are going to study. Second essay, that is a Trumpet Club by that is the Richard Steele. In the next session, I am going to speak on Trumpet Club, how Richard Steele is going to present the whimsicalities of the people and how he could try to expose the manners of the people that we can find and try to understand in the next session. Thank you for listening and understanding the few information of Richard Steele. Thank you. Let us meet in the next session. Thank you for attending and listening to the class.